Good morning, students. How are you all? So, Rajay, today we are going to begin with the 9th chapter from the part of social studies, as the name of chapter is Diversity in Festival and Dance. I know you all are completely aware with the word diversity, because we had already completed down the understanding of word diversity and diversity in food and clothes in the first term. Okay, so as now in the second term, a little bit variation will be there in your chapter, that is diversity in festival and dance. As you all know that we are completely different from one another. So we too have a different festivals, we too have a different dance forms and even different musics as well. So today we are going to understand the festivals of India and the dances of India. So before starting that, few questions are given down here. Let us discuss that. How many festivals you can name which are celebrated in India? So we know India is known as a festival of a country of festival. So there are lot many festivals. Diwali is there, Dussehra, Gurpurab, and lot many. When I am unable to pronounce each and every name, so students, you have to tell me that how many festivals you can name which are celebrated in India. Do you know why these festivals are going to be celebrated down? As we celebrated these festivals, but what is actually the history behind these celebrations? So we are going to understand that in this chapter. What special thing did you do on this festival? So what are the specialities of that festival that is also being discussed down by us? So festivals of India. We all know that India is actually known for their a lot many festival. So festival is a day when people celebrate an important or joyous event. So festival, we celebrate festival with our family, with our friends, and definitely these festivals have some kind of religious values as well. So some kind of religious beliefs are also relates down with these festivals. So some of the religious festival that we are going to understand, the first one is Dussehra. So I think you all are completely aware with the name of Ravan. So we burn down the statue of or effigy of Ravan, Kumbhakaran and Meghnad on Dussehra. So why we did these kind of things on Dussehra? Okay. So Dussehra is celebrated to mark the Lord Ram victory over Ravan. Okay, so just because Lord Ram won over the Ravan, Lord Ram ne, he was known as a pure soul, but Ravan is a cruel person. So Lord Ram actually defeat the Lord Ram ne kya kiya tha, Ravan ko hara diya tha us din. That is why we are celebrating the Dussehra. Okay, so this festival reminds us burai pe achhai ki jeet, good over evil. Okay, so that is representing the burai pe achhai ki jeet. Okay, so various shows are organized in the artist and life of Ram and his battle with Ravan, and definitely as I told you that we burn these kind of effigies to celebrate these festivals. Okay, so moving further, after the few days of the Dussehra, we will meet with the Diwali. So we all know that Diwali is considering to be the festival of light. Everywhere when we see, we can able to see the colorful lights were hanging on the doors of the home. The diyas, the candles are being burned by the people in front of their house just to celebrate the joy. Okay, but what is the reason behind celebrating this Diwali? Why we are celebrating this Diwali? Just because at this day, at the day of Diwali, our Lord Rama came to Ayodhya after 14 years of exile. Exile means Rajay Banvas. So Lord Rama came to Ayodhya at their home place because he was belonging from Ayodhya na. So he goes at the Banvas. So he goes at the exile, but after defeating down the रावण लॉर्ड रामा केम बैक टू अयोध्या आफ्टर 14 ईयर्स. सो दिस वॉज कंसिडरिंग अ वेरी जॉयफुल मूवमेंट फॉर द पीपल ऑफ अयोध्या एंड हिंदूज टू हैव अ ग्रेट बिलीव इन द लॉर्ड रामा. सो दैट इज़ वाई वी सेलिब्रेटेड द दिवाली. यूजली पीपल वॉर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ न्यू क्लोथ्स. दे गिफ्टेड ईच अदर द डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स और डिफरेंट गिफ्ट्स टू ईच अदर. वी gave sweets to our friends and family members, and definitely this festival has a very importance, a great importance in the India. Okay, so moving further, the next festival that is also very important one. So the next one is Guru Nanak Gurpurab. So this festival is also relates with the happiness and joy. So why we celebrate this festival? Why we celebrate the Gurpurab? As this mark down the birth of first Sikh Guru, that is Guru Nanak Dev Ji. Okay. So at this day, the first Sikh Guru, that is Guru Nanak Dev Ji, has born down. So this is also known as Guru Nanak Jayanti. So we call this festival as a Guru Nanak Jayanti. What people did at this festival, they pray in the Gurudwaras and a plenty of a langar. Plenty of a langar matlab ki a complete service of a langar will be there in the Gurudwara just to celebrate this festival. Here you can able to see that people are sitting down and they are having their langar that is being served down in Gurudwara on the occasion of Gurpurab. Okay, so the next festival that is also very much important festival, that is Eid. So we all know that Eid is also a festival that is being celebrated by all the Muslims with a great joy. And along with the Muslims, some of the other peoples are there, Hindus, Sikh, and lot many people are there who do respect this festival. Okay. So this festival celebrated down to mark the end of month fasting. Fasting hote hai Rajay? Vart. Okay, so when it ended down, so that day is being representing down the Eid, and this month is known as Ramadan. Okay, so at this day what happened, the people wear usually the new clothes. Okay, so and after wearing the new clothes, they go to the mosque and read the namaz. Okay, so various delicious sweets are being made down by them. Vermicelli is there, Raji, it is kind of a semia. Okay, so milk and dry fruit is also being used down and preparing for the sweets. Okay, people give clothes and gift to the poor people just to celebrate this festival. So moving further, the next festival that we are going to discuss down is Christmas. So Christmas, we all know why we celebrate this festival, just because this representing the birth of Jesus Christ. Okay, on 25th of December every year we celebrate the Christmas. On your birthday we celebrate your birthday na. So similarly, Christmas is considering a birthday of Jesus Christ. So people usually decorate their houses a Christmas tree with a green color tree and prepare with the Christmas bells, and lot many things will be done on that tree, and with stars, frills, toys, gifts. So everything is completely covered down and so beautifully and gracefully that tree is being decorated down, and people light candles and sing carols and church on Christmas Eve. Gift card, cake are shared with the friends and family. Okay. So the day when Jesus Christ was crucified is called the Good Friday, and it is a day of mourning. So Rajay, what is the meaning of crucified? Let me show you that. To punish a person by fastening his or her to a wooden cross. So किसी person को काफ़ी ज़्यादा बुरी तरह से punish करना, that is representing by this word. And mourning means it is representing the sadness. It shows the sadness. as when someone dead. Okay, so this day is marked as a mourning as well. So it is believed that the Jesus Christ came back to the life after 2 days. So this day is celebrated as an Easter. So moving further, the next one, let's explore. Firstly, read the let's explore. What is included in that? It is believed that Christmas Santa Claus distribute gifts and toys to children. What gift do you want from the Santa and why? So I will definitely ask you about this answer. Just think about this, which gift you wanted down from the Santa and what is the reason behind that for demanding that gift, that particular gift from the Santa. So moving further, as I already told that India is a land of festival. So it is not possible and let it ended down with 2 or 3 festival. There are lot many festival. So firstly discuss about the other festival that are pending down here. So one is Buddha Purnima. So the birth of Gautam Buddha was there. So that day was celebrated as a Buddha Purnima. And when the birth of Lord Mahavir was there, so that day was celebrated as Mahavir Jayanti. So moving further, the Pongal is also being celebrated in Tamil Nadu, particularly in January. So people cook rice with jaggery. Jaggery kya hota hai Rajay? What is the meaning of jaggery? Jaggery is representing the good. So people cook down the rice with jaggery and milk on this day. And just they thank the sun, rain, farm animals who help them to harvest their crops. Jinhone unki help ki crops ko ugane mein, crops ko harvest karne mein, they are just saying thanks. This is just a way to thank those people. Sun, rain, farm animal, these all are helping us a lot just to harvest their crops. So just the people celebrate the Pongal festival, particularly in Tamil Nadu in January, and thank the sun, rain and farm animals. Moving further, we are Punjabi and we completely know about the Lohri. So we celebrated the Lohri in January and this is particularly celebrated down in the Nadran India. It means where we are living, it is completely, not completely we can able to say, it is actually a festival of Punjab particularly. So people celebrated this festival with great joy. So they light bonfires. Here you can able to see this bonfire. So they place down the woods, pieces of wood there and light up them. So this is known as a bonfire. So they celebrate with peanuts, scones and jaggery. So these are the various things. You all are completely aware how we celebrate this festival with great joy and enthusiasm. So this festival also provide us a great and unending happiness. So moving further, the next festival that is very much famous in Assam, that is Bihu. Okay, so Bihu is considering a harvest festival that is celebrated in Assam. So moving further, the next festival that is celebrated in Kerala, that is Onam. So it is a rice harvest festival. Elephants are decorated and even they take as a procession boat races and held on the Onam. So Onam festival is also a very beautiful festival that is celebrated in Kerala. So they decorated the elephant in so beautiful manner just to celebrate this festival. And another festival that is particularly celebrated again in Punjab, that is Baisakhi. So it is a harvest festival and it is marked as a beginning of or a starting of Sikh New Year. And we all celebrated the festival Baisakhi as well with a great joy. So you can able to understand, we are living in that country where we have a lot many festival to celebrate. Dashera is there, Diwali is there, Gurpurab is there, Eid is there, Christmas is there, Buddha Purnima is there, Mahavir Jayanti is there, Pongal is there, Lohri is there, Bihu is there, Onam is there, and one of my favorite as well, that is Baisakhi, is also
there. So just tell me when we got a connectivity or when we meet live, that which one festival is your favorite one, okay? So moving further, now we are going to understand about the national festival. So Rajay, we already came to know about the religious festival. Religious festival, the festival that is somehow relate with the religious values. So moving further, the next one that is there is the national festival. So national festival is representing the Independence Day, Republic Day and Gandhi Jayanti. We too celebrate these festivals in the school as well. If you don't forget, we always celebrate every year in the school as well. We celebrate the Independence Day. The students goes down in the Dana Mandi or nearby the places where the function is being organized down of 15th August and they presented their performances there. So Independence Day is celebrated on 15th August every year. So why we celebrate this day? Because at this day India won the freedom from the British rule. Rajay, before independence, before 1947, we all are the slaves of the Britishers. Hum Britishers ke gulam the. On Independence Day we actually got down the freedom from the Britishers. And do you know that India was under the control of Britisher for about 200 years? 200 years के अराउंड इंडिया ने ब्रिटिशर्स के अंदर रहकर काम किया है एंड फाइनली ऑन 15th August 1947 वी गॉट द इंडिपेंडेंस. हमें इंडिपेंडेंस मिली दैट वी आर कम्प्लीटली फ्री टू वट सो एवर वी वॉन्ट टू डू. सो इन दैट डे वी होस्टेड आर नेशनल फ्लैग एंड होस्टेड ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट प्लेसेस एंड द बिल्डिंग. So this is particularly or mainly held in the Red Fort of India, Red Fort in Delhi. So the Prime Minister of India, who is the Prime Minister of India? So still the Prime Minister of India is our Honorable Prime Minister, that is Narendra Modi, okay? So unfurls that the national flag and address the people, and on this day we remember our great freedom fighter who gave up their life for freedom of our country. So we remember those souls who fought for us, for who fought for our independence with the Britishers. So they lose their life just to fight for our independence. So we remembering those freedom fighters as well. So moving further, the next one that is here is the Republic Day. So Republic Day is celebrated on 26 January and on this day in year 1950 India became a republic and the power of the government was passed into the hands of the Indian. So Indians are the one who are completely free to take down the decision. So Republic Day parades will be organized down, or it is actually being held down from last past years as well. So the main parade is held at Rajpath in Delhi. Jo Republic Day ki main sabse badi parade jo mani jati hai, parade is being done down like this way, okay? So wo kahan pe hoti hai? That was held at Rajpath, and the President of India, who is the President of India, this is, you have to search it by yourself, who is the President of India. So kindly search this answer. So when we have meeting, I'll surely ask you this question. So the President of India takes the salute of the parade, and many soldiers receive a bravery award and medal from the President of India. Defense weapon from the different state, colorful programs by folk singers, and the children's are the part of this parade. So this parade is considering to be a very huge parade. So soldiers who did something over the great bravery, they receive their gratitudes, they receive their medals, they receive their awards from the President. So President is considering down to be the first citizen of India. So it is a very high part of thing, or it is a very big thing to receive down a medal or reward from the President. So a soldier who did bravery, hota hai Rajay, bahaduri, who did something with a great bravery. So they received down the medals and awards on this occasion. So moving further, the next one that is there is Gandhi Jayanti. So Gandhi Jayanti, we all know that it's celebrated down on 2nd of October, and many people actually came down at the Rajghat and they do the prayers and flowers at the Mahatma Gandhi Samadhi. So this is a Samadhi of Mahatma Gandhi. So the prayers are being done down here and the people shower the flowers here just to represent or just to pay tribute or just to give a heartfelt gratitude to the Mahatma Gandhi. So who is Mahatma Gandhi? Mahatma Gandhi is known as a father of our nation because he played a very important role in the freedom struggle. We discussed now that on the Independence Day we got independence. Okay, so that is why we celebrating that day. And lot many freedom fighters are also there who sacrifices their life just to provide us a good life. So Mahatma Gandhi is considering to be a very important freedom fighter or freedom struggler. So moving further, as we are discussing about the diversity, so we already came to know about the diversity in the different festival. So religious festivals are there and the national festivals are there. So now we are going to understand about the dances of India. So the particularly the dances in our country is divided into two parts. The first one is a classical and the second one is folk dance. So the classical dance forms like Kathak is there, Odissi is there, Bharatanatyam is there, Kuchipudi is there. So these all are the examples of the classical dance forms, and some of the people prefer to do the classical dance form, but on the contrary some are there who prefer to do the folk dance form. So folk dance forms that was there, so I'm just telling the examples of folk dance form as well. Bhangra, we all are completely aware about Bhangra, and we number of people are there in Punjab who love the Bhangra. Even Gidda is there, Garba is there, Dandiya is there, Chumar is there. So these all are the examples of the folk dance. Usually we do this folk dance on the happiness occasion, or we perform some of the religious occasions as well, harvest festival or the beginning of the new season. So these dances are mainly done just to represent or just to showcase their happiness. So this is all about the chapter. I think you all are completely clear with the chapter. Now what you have to do, that you have to read down thoroughly this chapter from the book, and after reading this chapter you have to solve the exercise, try to solve the exercise which is given at the end of the chapter. And Rajit, try to solve this exercise by yourself even without taking help of anyone.